Hi everyone, it's Kara Pop. Today I'm gonna read a story called My Chincoteague Pony by Susan Jeffers. Julie loved ponies. Her room was filled with them. She read Misty of Chincoteague over and over again. On the dairy farm where she lived, there were cows and chickens, but no ponies. Sometimes she would visit her friend Sharon's horse, Shanty. She loved his soft muzzle and the way he breathed on her hand. He was gentle and took her wherever she asked him to go. But she longed for a pony of her own. Julie knew that every July there was a pony auction on Chincoteague Island in Virginia. After months of trying, she finally convinced her parents that she could earn enough money to buy one of the famous ponies. Maybe there would be one that no one else wanted, or one that didn't cost too much. Julie raked leaves, fed the chickens, and babysat her cousins. She cleared out the tool shed and put straw down for a soft bed. It was a perfect home for a new pony. At last it was July. While Dad stayed home to take care of the farm, Julie and her mother drove to Chincoteague Island for Pony Penning Day. As they crossed the bridge to Chincoteague, they could see nearby Assateague Island where the ponies run free. Julie knew the legend of the ponies. Many, many years ago, a Spanish galleon was said to have been shipwrecked off Assateague Island. It spilled its cargo of ponies into the sea. The ponies swam ashore and survived on the island. The ponies learned to live on Assateague through all the seasons. They grew strong and beautiful, and new babies were born every year. But soon there were too many ponies and not enough food for them all. So every summer, the fire department of Chincoteague Island holds a roundup of the pony herd on Assateague. Fire department volunteers, known as saltwater cowboys, swim some of the ponies across a narrow channel from Assateague to Chincoteague. Then the cowboys carefully guide the ponies to the fairgrounds in town. The evening before the auction, Julie and her mother went to the pens at the fairgrounds and looked at all the ponies. Julie felt as if her heart would burst. The ponies were all so beautiful. A black and white filly came over and looked at Julie. "If you were mine," whispered Julie, "I would call you Dream, Painted Dream." The next morning, Julie was too excited to eat. She and her mom headed straight for the auction. Julie soon realized that she did not have enough money. She kept raising her hand to make a bid, but every time the price climbed too high. Julie's eyes filled with tears as one pony after another was sold, even the black and white filly. "Don't give up," said a woman sitting next to her. "Keep calling out your bid. Persistence pays off." And she handed Julie a $20 bill. "Thank you, but we really can't," Julie's mother began. But then a little boy gave Julie a dollar. "It looks like everyone wants you to have a pony of your own," her mother said, smiling. "Thank you," Julie exclaimed as more strangers passed her money. Her heart leaped. Now she might have enough to buy her pony. But it was too late. All the ponies had been sold. As the last ponies were being taken out of the auction arena, a man shouted, "Wait! A pony has been returned. The barn where she was going won't take a foal." "Don't leave, folks," the auctioneer said. "We have one more pony to sell." It was the black and white pony, Painted Dream. The auctioneer looked straight at Julie. Her heart pounded and her hand shot in the air.
"Going once, going twice, sold to the little girl in the first row."
"Well," said her mother, "what are you going to do now that you have your dream?"
"I have a lot of work to do. First, I have to gentle my pony. Then I'm going to do chores, save all my money, and come back next year."
"Isn't one pony enough?" her mother asked, laughing.
"No," said Julie. "I'm going to give my money to another girl so that she can buy a pony of her own." And that is just what she did.
It's Kara Pop here, guys. I hope you enjoyed that story as much as I did. And I want to wish you all a wonderful day, and God bless. Don't forget to subscribe for more great books.